designed to spec, even worse, because that means they're putting lives in danger.
Yeah.
If you go too thin on that stuff, you get exactly what you're talking about. You get a meltdown.
Yeah.
And we're at meltdown, the tipping point. You know about the tipping point?
Yeah.
What do you know about it?
We're there. We're
actually past it.
The point of no return?
There's been 5 extinctions on Earth. This will be the 6th. Mankind didn't evolve until the 6th evolution.
Yeah.
And there were 10 million life forms. Now we've eradicated more than 8 million of them. And they're predicting that with the global warming and all the stuff that's going to release, it's been hidden in ice for, I don't know how many years. How are you, buddy?
Changing it?
No, it's good.
I actually pulled up and looked at them, and they're both good. But last night, all right. Yeah, I was busting his balls. Maybe the right one's out of line. Maybe that's why it looks fucked up. I mean, different. Turn on the car. Ooh, my car is on.
I will keep in touch.
Okay, yeah, please do.
No worries.
And you can follow in the news centers on my site. Stuff with it. That's bright. That's dim. Well, I know they are, but the dim just seemed low on the right side when I was driving last night, so I had brights on all night. People were like flashing me, like turning them on. I'm like,
everything cool?
No. I honestly know.
Are some things cool?
I don't know that anything's cool, but let me just say, when you get to the point in your life where you have to spend days with people like that.
Especially a woman, that sucks.
Yeah, but read what she does. She works at the State Department, and she's a special agent for diplomatic services. So I guess I must be the diplomatic type, but the FBI and DOD and other people are making my life fucking miserable because Paris and Moscow happened as a result of my hack, because I was voice for all the intelligence around the world, from satellites to intel communication. I try to let them know. I try to let them know on October 28th. They all blew me off. Like, why do you even have it? Well, let me think. You sent me the video and the script so I could be the fucking voice for it. That's why I fucking have it, you asshole. Now stop giving me a hard way. And they're like, okay, we're done. Click. Hello? Click?
Good luck with it all, man.
And so I've been pushing every branch of government to wake the fuck up. And I finally wrote the White House this morning. I may even republish the letter publicly, but I'll have to eradicate certain things like the exact manual they took and stuff like that.
This is so terrible, man.
Well, NBC's talking about having me be on the nightly news either tonight or tomorrow night. This breaking news story, and then Today Show the next day.
What time? I'm going to watch
it. I have no idea. Sometime in the next. I don't have your number. How am I going to text you?
Next week.
There we go. I have to put you. I don't think so. Yeah,
try my numbers.
Yeah, you can just put it in and save a card. Give it to somebody who needs it. Hang on. Oh my God, everybody's texting
That's
me.
Cool.
Oh boy.
Oh,
you know what? Before we do this, we do this about that. You should actually put everything in, like email and stuff in Jawea, so when other shit comes up, because there's a lot of times I get invited to parties. Well, I don't actually call people. I just text them. Here's all this shit going on.
Is that WhatsApp?
It's what WhatsApp. Yeah. I mean, sometimes I'll put a whole list of where we're going to. Like, I go with John Barrymore and other people. Sometimes we get like 8 to 10 red carpets in a night. And they have free food and drinks because they want us to come. So we go. I mean, there's nothing wrong with that, is there? I live that kind of life. Do you have a cigarette?
I don't know.
Neither do I, so I guess I'll have to smoke this instead.
Sure, man. That smells
good. No, it is. Hold it. And you didn't put in the notes, and you didn't put in your birthday. How am I going to send you a birthday card? And you didn't put in where we met.
Here's my card. You can call and yell at me anytime.
Well, if you hang on a second, I'll plug you into the phone also, because I don't even see cell phone on here.
No, well, let me get myself.
Well, hang on to that note for something else. I'll just have to put it in here, and you can save a card for somebody else who doesn't have technology.
No, I got a customer that just walked in.
All right. Can you put his in for him? He'll put it in for you, Larry. He's at Mr. and Mrs. Pacific University.
Yeah, of course. And I'm not any smarter.
You forgot. Oh, no, you did put in a birthday on it. And notes. How about Matt? Matt? Fire stone. Okay, so save. And I have no idea what it is, but we'll mark it there, and we'll see. The very first text goes to Alan now. What did I give? Oh, dumping ground. Wow. Well, we'll see some of the stuff that I sent to NBC.
All right.
And then could you put in Funny Man stuff?
That's his right there.
Yeah, but I mean...
He doesn't even have an email.
I'm just asking you if you would enter it, because I'm too tired to work today. I've decided to take the day off, because I can... Oh, which side of town do you live in?
I live in Tarzana.
I used to live over there. We're looking for people who know how to do television and film production, because I've got J.P. Morgan backing me to $1 billion per network, and I'm launching 6 international networks in the next 5 years. So with $6 to $10 billion, I'm sure I can afford to hire some people. Do you know anybody who does production work? Or?
Not really, man. But I'll definitely... You just shot me a text. I got it here.
Oh, yeah. I shot it before I even shot him one, but he should have one also. All right.
You
both
let me straight. It may be 25 to 30 years. I'm not sure how many years I've known Bill, but I didn't want to misquote anything. What? Hey, did you see the thing about me being inducted into the Radio Museum Hall of Fame thing for television and radio? I sent it to you, and I even sent you a video clip that's definitely being inducted. The one they claim is the most popular clip of all time, me doing an ad for the American Cancer Society at NBC while I'm in a black leather jacket smoking a cigarette on the air. It is the most requested bit. People want to come and see it all the time. I just did it out of spoof. I thought it was funny, but, you know, I guess it works sometimes when I think I'm funny. Other people do, too. You should look at it. I sent you the clip. I sent it to your NBC address. All right, love, thank you for everything you're doing. I truly appreciate it. All right. Such a roller coaster. No, don't hold me in spots. If you can be spontaneous and you're free and I'm free, I will let you know. But otherwise, I don't want to tell you up tonight because there's too much up in the air. We'd have to play by ear both nights. Unfortunately, with the security breaches with Homeland Paranoia, they're sucking up a little bit of my time with things they want me to do, so... I actually don't get a vote in this because I have to comply with federal law. Yeah, it's So, I'm doing the best I can. Hopefully, I'll be out of this pile of doo-doo soon. Because I surely need some help, but right now my dysfunctional uncle's calling the shots. Yeah. What's the latest you can do tonight? Okay, and tomorrow? Right. And do you have anything on the weekend or not? Well, if you don't mind texting those windows when I'm not driving, I'll check the calendar and see where I can fit something in and get back to you. Yeah, because I'm driving, so I would be guessing at any time I picked right now, and I don't want to do that to you. That's not fair. Thank you. So appreciate it. Thank you very much. All right. Thanks. Bye. Oh, dear God. Love you, Claire. Okay. Let's see what I want to do. Oh, dude. Really? Well, now I see what the problem is, but you guys didn't read a... What was the original cost of this project? I don't even remember it, honestly. Okay, the problem is I now have to pay somebody to go back in Studio Archives, which we have huge terabytes of archives, so it takes a long time for them to search for stuff. Unless you know exactly what the files are that we're looking for, and even then it still takes time to search all of that, because we've moved to a fully encrypted system, so the encryption does run slower because it's very secure. We're at government grade 256. So as long as nobody took it in the hack that we had, we'll get it to you. But there is a charge for the studio time because, again, I got to pay someone to go dig this up. I don't do that for free. Can't. Okay. You know what? It's usually we do half rate unless we're doing a read, then we do three quarter rate. But I'll go see what we can adjust. It's just you need to also be aware if we had. I don't think we did because we billed you through PayPal, right? Okay. I'm just giving you a heads up. We were hacked so bad that the FBI, Sony, and everybody is involved in this, literally, including Homeland Security, because when they breached my network, they got everybody's everything, including government intel, and that's why Paris and Moscow went off. So, seriously, I'm just giving you a heads up. There's goofy stuff going on in the world right now, and what they're telling me is that we're at the highest levels of security worldwide because of this. And you should just shop in your neighborhood with local people and not be going into big malls between now and the end of the year. Just a quick heads up to you so you can share with your family and friends. They're even saying it's better not to order stuff offline because, again, you're putting your credit card out there and you're letting people know exactly where you live versus picking up stuff in your neighborhood, which makes it a little more ambiguous. So, just a heads up. Sorry for the interruption, but I think it's important enough to share with everyone I talk to, since it was my network that was breached, and they knew it in October, and they sat on their fucking asses and didn't do anything. I actually wrote a letter to the president today and called that up and said, why did you guys sit on this for so long? So, it's just, it really annoys me that we've taken this posture like, oh, how did this happen? When they knew a long time ago they could have prevented it. Oh, well. Yeah, and it's not my call, but it is my call if I decide to blow a big whistle that gets loud and invoke protection, because then they can't allegedly touch me. But, hey, they got Kennedy and Martin Luther and the other Kennedy, so I'm not banking on the fact they would not whack my ass, too, so I got to be careful how loud when that whistle blows. If people know who's blowing it, I think I'll just be deep-throated. No one will ever know who the fuck I am, because that'll keep me alive. That's what I'm thinking. Because anything less will get me killed. So I'm thinking I need to find some good security guys before this thing goes public. I've even told NBC I'll give them a first look at a series with John Barrymore and myself. Or if they don't like that one, they can have a first look at the whole Barrymore family heritage that John would tell them. And they said, oh no, don't muddy the waters. Keep the news story separate. And I'm like, okay, we can do that. But I still want a big cash advance because I need to change my lifestyle once this goes public. Do you understand? Oh, yeah. Oh, my God. Help me, God. So if you know any good security people who understand high-level intel, I might need a few. I'm sorry, what?